Good day. My paper is titled Utility of Structural MRI and Diffusion Weighted Imaging in the Evaluation of Uterine and Adnexal Lesions. The aim of the presentation is to assess the efficacy of MRI in identification and characterization of uterine and adnexal lesions, to differentiate between benign and malignant lesions using structural MRI and DWI, to determine the significance of ADC values in differentiating benign and malignant lesions. In females, uterine and adnexal pathologies have been the common cause of morbidity. Although most of them are benign, malignant ones are associated with significant risk of mortality. Hence, accurate diagnosis is of utmost importance for timely intervention, which can be done using MRI. Although USG is the mainstay in female pelvic pathologies, MRI is better used on account of its good tissue resolution, multiplanar imaging capacity, and excellent tissue differentiation ability, which can help in making the definitive diagnosis. Adnexal masses whose origin and nature is difficult to be detected in USG are better evaluated by MRI because of its precision in characterizing the lesion and defining the tissue of origin. DWI is a functional imaging sequence. It works on the principle of random mobility of water molecules within the tissues. Different tissues have variable water diffusion, which provides a good image contrast and obviates the need for exogenous contrast administration. Obtained DWI image is analyzed qualitatively by using different strengths of diffusion sensitizing gradient, B values, and quantitatively using ADC maps. MRI with DWI imaging emerged as an optimistic tool in detection and characterization of various uterine and adnexal lesions, their anatomical extension, understanding the pathophysiology by ADC values, which further helps in differentiation of benign and malignant lesions. In our study, we have evaluated the features of various lesions of uterus and adnexa based on their appearance on T1 weighted imaging, T2 weighted imaging, STIR, T1 FS, GRE, post contrast enhancement, diffusion restriction, and ADC values. In addition, the accuracy of MRI in the identification and distinction of benign from malignant lesions was assessed on the basis of the ADC values determined from the DWI sequence and verified by histopathological diagnosis. This was a prospective observational study conducted at a tertiary center over a period of 2 years from September 2018 to August 2020. A total 100 patients of all age groups were included who were suspected of uterine and adnexal lesions. Examination was done under Siemens Avanto Magnetic Resonance Imaging 1.5 Tesla machine. Post-operative and post-radiation therapy patients, congenital anomalies of uterus, and pregnant patients with adnexal masses were excluded from our study. Patient was positioned with head towards magnet, body coil placed over the abdomen and pelvis and secured using straps. Beam centering was done over the iliac crest. Planes and sequences included T1 weighted imaging in axial coronal planes, T2 weighted imaging in axial coronal and sagittal planes, diffusion weighted imaging in axial planes, STIR image in axial coronal and sagittal planes, T1 FS in axial plane, and gradient echo in sagittal and axial plane with contrast whenever required with slice thickness of 5 mm. Continuous variables like age and ADC were expressed as mean, standard deviation. The association of ADC with type of lesion was separately assessed for both uterine and adnexal lesions using a chi-square test. The mean differences in ADC between benign and malignant were compared using a student t-test. Receiver operating characteristic curve of the ADC values used for differentiating benign from malignant lesions was plotted separately for both uterine and adnexal lesions. Accuracy of ADC cutoff value to differentiate benign from malignant lesions were assessed by Kappa statistic. A p-value of less than 0.05 was considered as statistically significant. Patients in our study varied from 9 to 72 years of age. The mean age for benign and malignant uterine lesions was 41.9 years and 57.1 years respectively. The mean age for benign and malignant adnexal lesions was 38.6 years and 50.1 years respectively. 54 out of 100 cases were uterine and cervical lesions, while 46 out of 100 were adnexal lesions. Among the uterine and cervical lesions, 32, that is 57.4%, were fibroids, 7, that is 12.9%, adenomyosis, 3, 5.6%, carcinoma endometrium, and 12, 22.2%, carcinoma cervix. Among the adnexal lesions, 36, 78.2% lesions were ovarian, which included 8 endometriomas, 6 serous cystadenomas, 3 mucinous cystadenoma, 3 hemorrhagic cysts, 3 simple ovarian cysts, 3 mature teratoma, 1 fibrothecoma, 1 case of torsion ovary, and 10 cases of carcinoma, which constituted 21.8% cases. 10 cases were extraovarian, that is comprising 21.8% of the adnexal lesions, of which 5 were tubo-ovarian abscesses, 3 were hydrosalpinx, and 2 were para-ovarian cysts. In total, 77 of the 100 cases were benign and 23 of the 100 were malignant. Among the 54 uterine lesions, 39 cases, that is 72.2%, were benign, while 15 cases, that is 27.8%, were malignant. Carcinoma cervix constitutes the maximum with 12 out of 15 of the malignant lesions. Among the 46 adnexal lesions, 38, that is 82.6%, were benign, while 8, that is 70.4%, cases were malignant. On division of adnexal lesions into solid, cystic and solid cystic based on appearance, 6 out of 8 malignant lesions showed predominantly solid cystic appearance on MRI, and majority of benign lesions showed cystic appearance, which was helpful in differentiation of malignant from benign lesions with a significant p-value of less than 0.001. This is shown in the table 1. Blood-containing benign lesions in our study included 8 endometriomas and 3 hemorrhagic cysts. Both these lesions showed blooming on GRE and chronic cases showing diffusion restriction with no post-contrast enhancement. The T2 dark spot sign was seen in 4 out of 8, that is 50% of endometriomas, and 0 cases of hemorrhagic cysts, whereas the T2 shading sign was seen in 7 out of 8, that is 87.5% cases of endometriomas and 1 of the 3 hemorrhagic cysts. In T2-weighted imaging in our study, all malignant uterine lesions appeared hyper-intense on T2-weighted imaging. Out of the 39 benign uterine and cervical lesions, 31 showed hypo-intense signal and 8 showed hyper-intense signal characteristics. Out of the 38 benign adnexal lesions, 20, that is 52.6%, showed hypo-intense signal on T1-weighted imaging. 13 cases, that is 34.2%, showed hyper-intense signal, whereas 5 cases showed iso-intense signal characteristics. In T1FS post-contrast images in our study, contrast was given in 30 uterine lesions and 27 adnexal lesions. Out of the 30 uterine lesions, all the 15 malignant lesions showed heterogeneous contrast enhancement, but none of the benign lesions showed any enhancement. Of the 27 adnexal lesions, 57.9% benign cases showed no contrast enhancement. However, 26.3% benign lesions showed peripheral enhancement and 15.8% benign lesions showed enhancing septae. Of the malignant lesions, 87.5% lesions showed heterogeneous post-contrast enhancement and 12.5% malignant lesions also showed enhancing septae. Diffusion-weighted imaging was done in all the cases and ADC values were calculated at a B value of 800 wherever required. None of the benign uterine lesions and all the malignant uterine lesions showed diffusion restriction, which is shown in Table 2 subsequently. The mean ADC value for benign uterine lesions was 1.33 plus 0.18 into 10 raised to minus 3 millimeter square per second, and for malignant lesions was 0.77 plus 0.08 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm square per second. So there is a considerable difference. The ROC curve of ADC value was plotted, and ADC cutoff value of 0.92 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm square per second was suggested for differentiating benign and malignant uterine lesions with a sensitivity, specificity, positive predictive value, and negative predictive value of 100%. Of 38 benign adnexal lesions, 17, that is 44.8% lesions, showed diffusion restriction, whereas 21 showed no restriction, and all the 8 malignant lesions showed diffusion restriction, again depicted in Table 2. The mean ADC values for benign adnexal lesions was 1.35 plus 0.78 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm square per second, and for malignant lesions was 0.91 plus 0.03 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm square per second. The ROC curve of the ADC value was plot, and ADC cutoff value of 0.96 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm square per second was suggested for differentiating benign from malignant adnexal lesions. 47% endometriomas and 23.5% tubo-ovarian abscesses showed diffusion restriction with low ADC values. The mean ADC value for endometrioma was 0.69 plus 0.03 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm square per second, and the mean EDC value for tubo ovarian abscess was 0.46 plus 0.06 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm square per second. Hence, statistically, EDC cutoff value of 0.96 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm square per second was not significant in differentiating benign from malignant adnexal lesions with a kappa value of 0.3 and p-value of 0.37. with sensitivity, specificity, positive predictive value, and negative predictive values of 100%, 55.2%, 32%, and 100%, respectively. So this is the table 2 summarizing the findings in the above two slides. Moving on, we correlated MRI findings with histopathology, postoperative findings, and biochemical parameters, follow-up diagnosis, and other modalities like ultrasound wherever possible. Out of the 100 proved cases, MRI diagnosed 99 cases correctly. From our study, the sensitivity, specificity, positive predictive, negative predictive value, and accuracy of MRI in detecting and differentiating benign and malignant uterine and adnexal lesions was 95%, 100%, 100%, 98.72%, and 99% respectively, with a strong kappa value. Uterine and adnexal lesions constitute a major cause of morbidity among women of all ages. All-inclusive maximum pathologies arise from the uterus followed by the adnexa. Among all uterine lesions, fibroids are the commonest, followed by carcinoma cervix. Prasad et al. Reported a definite prevalence of benign lesions in women less than 50 years of age and malignant lesions among those more than 50 years. Among uterine, cervical, and adnexal lesions, most malignant lesions, that is 15 out of 23 cases, were noted arising from the cervix. Most common benign lesions are uterine fibroids followed by epithelial benign ovarian tumors. While USG remains the first investigation of choice, MRI helps in accurate localization and characterization of uterine and adnexal lesions which are doubtful on USG. For example, on USG, perinculated large subserous fibroids and adnexal masses may present a diagnostic dilemma which can successfully be overcome by demonstrating the bridging vessel sign of subserosal fibroids and MRI, which is depicted in figure 1. Bridging vessels appear as curvilinear tortuous flow voids between the mass in question and uterus. Subserosal fibroids with sizes more than 3 cm have a higher sensitivity and specificity for this sign. So in figure 1, we can see MRI pelvis showing a large uterine subserosal fibroid in axial and coronal T2 weighted images with a large hypointense lesion in the right adnexa. The right ovary is seen separately from this lesion, and in image C and D, the axial T2 weighted images show bridging vessels, which is shown by the white arrow between the lesion and the right posterolateral wall of the uterus, confirming the finding of a subserous fibroid. On division of adnexal lesions into solid cystic and solid cystic, we observed that malignant lesions showed predominantly solid cystic appearance on MRI, which is helpful in differentiating from benign lesions. Our results corroborated with a study conducted by Prasad et al., which showed benign lesions are predominantly cystic while malignant lesions were solid cystic. We also observed that malignant uterine and cervical lesions showed high signal intensity on T2 sequence owing to the high cellularity, while benign lesions showed low signal intensity, making it a preferred sequence for structural differentiation of benign versus malignant uterine lesions. The T1 hyperintense signals seen in our study included fat and blood containing lesions like endometriomas, hemorrhagic cysts, and mature cystic teratomas. The diagnostic approach to T1 weighted image hyperintense adnexal lesions is shown in figure 3. We observe that post-contrast imaging can be best utilized for detecting and differentiating benign and malignant uterine and adnexal lesions. So in figure 2, we can see the diagnostic approach to uterine lesions which appear hyperintense or hypointense based on T2 weighted imaging. And on the left side in figure 3, there is a diagnostic approach to adnexal lesions showing hyperintense signal on T1 weighted imaging. In case of uterine lesions, if they have a low signal intensity on T2, it is likely fibroid or adenomyosis, whereas high signal intensity can be malignant tumor or fibroid with degeneration. Hence, contrast scan will help in differentiating between the two. Whereas a T1 hyperintense lesion subjected to fat sat imaging will, if it is suppressed, it is most likely a mucinous tumor or a blood-containing lesion like endometrium and hemorrhagic cyst, which after contrast enhancement shows different patterns. For example, septal and benign mucinous lesion, no enhancement in endometriotic cyst or hemorrhagic cyst, and heterogeneous enhancement in malignant lesions. Whereas if the fat cell image is again positive, it is a teratoma. Also, malignant uterine lesions show diffusion restriction with low ADC values, with significant difference in the ADC values between the normal tissue benign lesions and malignant lesions. Kilikismis et al. Observed a statistically significant difference in the ADC values of normal myometrium, endometrium, and endometrial carcinomas with malignant and benign lesions, showing mean ADC values of 1.05 plus minus 0.11 and 1.55 plus minus 0.33, respectively. A cutoff value for malignant lesions, 1.05 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm square per second, yielded a sensitivity, specificity, and accuracy of 95.83%, 94.55%, and 94.94%, respectively, in their studies. Various studies conducted by Dhanda et al., Coutinho et al., Lucas et al., Zhuowang et al., and R.C. Jha et al. Demonstrated that ADC measurements can quantitatively distinguish between normal and malignant uterine lesions. This was highly corroborative with our findings. Carcinoma cervix, which is given in the next figure, is the second most common malignancy among women after breast cancer. The modality of choice for assessment of tumor size and spread is MRI. MRI has a high negative predictive value of 95% for parametric invasion in cervical carcinoma. Also, it is documented with 100% NPV for urinary bladder or rectal invasion. MRI can obviate the necessity of invasive procedures and in turn reduces staging cost and morbidity. Naganawa et al. Observed that cervical carcinoma has been shown to demonstrate impeded diffusion relative to normal cervical stroma, and a significantly lower ADC has been reported in cervical carcinoma compared with that of normal cervix. Endometrial carcinoma is less common in India as compared to Western countries, which is evident in our study, which showed less number of cases in comparison to carcinoma cervix. MRI assessed in assessment of myometrial invasion depth, cervical invasion, and nodal metastasis. Shigenomo Motoshiba et al. Observed a likelihood of 22% of lesions with restricted diffusion might be benign and suggested an ADC value of 1.4 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm square per second and 1.15 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm square per second for differentiating between normal and cancerous tissue in uterus and endometrium, respectively. So here the MRI pelvis is showing a moderately differentiated squamous cell carcinoma cervix in a sagittal T2-weighted image showing bulky cervix with a large hyperintense lesion, B, axial T2-weighted image of the same, which is invading the parametrial and mesorectal fat planes, sagittal post-contrast enhanced image showing heterogeneous enhancement, and last are D and E showing diffusion restriction with low ADC value. Figure 5 is MRI pelvis of endometrial carcinoma, a sagittal image showing bulky uterus with irregular, heterogeneously hyperintense endometrial growth along the anterior wall with few calcific foci, and post-contrast T1FS image showing heterogeneous enhancement and diffusion restriction with corresponding low ADC values. In case of adnexal lesions, most malignant lesions and few benign lesions show diffusion restriction with low ADC values. Nevertheless, Koch et al. Observed that mean ADC values of malignant lesions were significantly lower than that of benign lesions for all B values. Endometriomas, hemorrhagic cysts, and tuboavian abscesses constitute the majority of benign lesions which show diffusion restriction. The T2 shading sign and T2 dark spot sign are helpful in differentiation of endometriomas from hemorrhagic cysts. T2 dark spot sign has high specificity for chronic hemorrhage and is useful to differentiate endometriomas from hemorrhagic cysts. The T2 shading sign is sensitive but not specific for endometriomas. Hence, use of DWS sequence alone cannot differentiate endometriosis and tubo-ovarian abscesses from malignant lesions. Chandanlal et al. Reported that decisions based on the appearance of DWS and NDC values alone may lead to ovarian tumors being misclassified as benign or malignant. Therefore, additional sequences like T1, T2, T1FS, and contrast are required for complete evaluation and differentiation. Moreover, tubo-ovarian abscesses will show peripheral contrast enhancement on T1FS contrast images, which helps in ruling out malignancy. So here in figure 6, we have an MRI pelvis showing bilateral ovarian endometriotic cysts, which appear as hyperintense cystic lesions in both ovaries, showing T2 shading sign. They also show diffusion restriction. Figure 7 shows tubo-ovarian abscess of the right adnexa which is showing peripheral hyperintense signal and central low intensity suggestive of necrosis. On T1 weighted image, it is appearing hypointense, and post-contrast imaging shows peripheral limb enhancement. It also is showing diffusion restriction in the necrotic components with corresponding low ADC values. In conclusion, MRI is an exceptional modality for identification, characterization, and classification of various uterine and adnexal lesions. We infer from our research that DWI plays a significant role in separating benign from malignant uterine lesions with an ADC cutoff value of 0.92 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm square per second, along with 100% sensitivity and specificity. Among adnexal lesions, diffusion restriction can be seen in both malignant and some benign lesions like endometriomas and tubo-ovarian abscesses. Because a wide range of benign adnexal lesions showed low ADC values, DWI has a limited role in differentiating and between benign and malignant adnexal lesions. However, irrespective of ADC values, a complete analysis of the lesions utilizing all sequences we had observed that MRI had a sensitivity, specificity, and accuracy of 95%, 100%, and 99% respectively in detecting uterine and adnexal lesions. Thank you.